Welcome to another UEN Teacher Tip. My name's Rob Bentley, and in this video, we're going to talk about student engagement. For many students and teachers, once the excitement of a new school year begins to fade, we can sometimes settle into a predictable routine that can get a little bit old for students and also for teachers. So in this video, we're going to talk about a tool called Adobe Express that we can use to increase student engagement. And we're going to focus specifically on the new artificial intelligence tool that's in Adobe Express. Utah public school teachers from kindergarten to 12th grade have access to Adobe Express through their district or school, and also public school students from grades 7 to 12 also have access to Adobe Express. Once you've gotten logged into Adobe Express, you should see a page similar to this one, and you can browse down the page until you find this tool, Text to Image. This is Generative Artificial Intelligence. You can click here to describe things, environment, people, or mood, and then Adobe Express will do its best using artificial intelligence to create an image that matches your description. Let's give it a try. So I'm going to prompt Adobe Express to produce an image of a tiger in a three-piece suit. Let's try that. I'll click Generate. And Adobe Express has produced this image. Now this is a unique image to me. This image didn't exist before I asked for it to be created. If I don't like that particular image, I can click to select other alternate images that I could choose from. And once I've found the image that I like, I can then go on to edit this image and add to it. I could click here in the upper left on this back arrow to go back to my other Adobe Express tools, and I could add some effects or some animation. And I can use these buttons here at the left to add things like additional images and text, even speech bubbles. So I'll just click and drag this speech bubble into the image, and I can resize that down. Double-click on the text to edit it. Once I'm done adding to the image or making adjustments to it, I can click here on Download to download a copy of this image in the file format that I prefer, and then I can just click Download, and a copy of this image is put onto my computer. I can then open up the image, and I can use it in my presentations, in my documents, in Canvas, or whatever it may be. Now, just because this artificial intelligence text-to-image tool is engaging and fun, that doesn't mean that we can't use this for educational purposes. There are many educational projects and uses for this text-to-image tool. For example, language arts teachers could have their students generate an image to illustrate different literary terms or concepts, for example, personification. So I could type here in this text prompt, a walking taco with arms, legs, and a face. I click Generate, and Adobe Express is producing, through artificial intelligence, an image that demonstrates personification. Students could do the same kind of thing with metaphors and similes and all sorts of other literary terms. In a world language course, teachers could give students a list of new vocabulary used creatively in sentences, and then the students can discover what the words mean by entering them into the text-to-image prompt box. You click Generate, and artificial intelligence will produce an image that will illustrate for the students what the Spanish or French or whatever it may be is describing. There are many other educational uses of text-to-image, but in addition to those examples that I've given, teachers and students can also use this to generate imagery for their presentations, for their worksheets and tests and quizzes, and their book reports and papers. So I want to challenge you to log in to your Adobe Express account and try using the text-to-image tool to generate images for your class materials and for your students, and also give your students the opportunity to use this artificial intelligence tool built into Adobe Express. It's a surefire way to increase student engagement. Thanks for watching this UEN Teacher Tip, and please come back to watch our next UEN Teacher Tip. Thank you.